In wars, it does not matter how many modern and superior combat aircrafts an air force possess. The thing that matters is the actual number of fully functional capable aircrafts that it can effectively use against its enemies. And such availability often depends on low maintenance and operational costs. In 1980s, Pakistan was operating Chinese Shenyang F-6 or J-6 in large numbers. The Shenyang J-6 or F-6 was the Chinese-built version of the Soviet MiG-19 supersonic fighter aircraft. This aircraft was valued for its agility, turning performance and powerful cannon armament. It had a maximum speed of Mach 1.45, service ceiling was 58,700 feet, combat radius with two drop tanks was about 640 kilometers. In addition to the internal cannon armament, most had provision for four wing payloads for up to 250 kg, each with a maximum ordnance load of 500 kg. The J-6 were intended to be operated for only 100 flight hours or approximately 100 sorties before being overhauled. The Pakistan Air Force was often able to extend this to 130 hours with diligent maintenance, but still these F-6 were becoming more and more difficult to maintain. Therefore, Pakistan decided to replace them with Nanchang A-5 and Chengdu F-7 or J-7 combat aircrafts. The Nanchang Q-5 or A-5 was a Chinese-built ground attack aircraft based on the Shenyang J-6. However, the aircraft was primarily used for close air support. Although based on the MiG-19, the new designated A-5 had a longer fuselage area rule to reduce transonic drag and accommodate a 13-foot long internal weapons bay. New wings with greater area and a reduced sweep were incorporated. The redesign caused some high altitude speed, but the A-5 was as fast as the MiG-19 or J-6 at low level. The Chengdu J-7 F-7 is a license-built Chinese version of the Soviet MiG-21 and thus shares many similarities with the MiG-21. The aircraft is armed with short-range infrared homing air-to-air missiles and mainly designed for short-range air-to-air combat. The aircraft also used for close air support. A-5 and F-7 remained in service up till 2011 and were backbone of Pakistan Air Force. An aircraft does not become obsolete just because of its age or model. It becomes obsolete when it becomes difficult to maintain or fails to serve its purpose. It happens when enemy introduces some more advanced aircrafts or anti-aircraft systems. In 1980s and 90s, Indian main combat air fleet consisted of large number of MiG-21s, and Pakistani A-5 and F-7 were capable of dealing these MiG. But in 1980s, India began to work on a light combat aircraft LCA program to replace its aging MiG-21 fighters. The LCA was officially named Tejas, and it was expected that the aircraft will be introduced in the mid-2000s in Indian Air Force and will replace the MiG-21s. Pakistan, on the other hand, was under US sanctions and was not in a position to purchase modern aircrafts to counter rapid Indian modernization of its air force. So Pakistan decided to develop its own fourth generation lightweight multi-role combat aircraft with the help of China. Initial objectives of this program were to replace the A-5, F-7, Mirage 3 and Mirage 5 combat aircraft in the Pakistan Air Force with a single modern aircraft that can be used for multiple roles, including interception, ground attack, anti-ship and aerial reconnaissance. But soon the Pakistani experts and designers realized that it is difficult to design a single aircraft that can replace all the above mentioned multi-role aircrafts. Therefore, they narrowed down their objectives and adopted a more realistic approach. Pakistan started a large-scale upgradation program to upgrade all those aircrafts that can be upgraded. Project ROSE, retrofit of strike element, was initiated by the Pakistan Aeronautical Complex for the upgrades of the military avionics and electronic systems of its aging Mirage 3 fighter jets. The program focused on modernization of the military avionics and onboard computer system of Mirage 3 and Mirage 5 supplied by Pakistani Margla Electronics, French SAGEM and the Italian SELEX Consortium. From 1996 to 2000, several Mirage 3 and Mirage 5 were bought from the other countries and were upgraded under this program at the Pakistan Aeronautical Complex. In this project, the avionics of the aircraft were increased. In-flight refueling was added. Due to this, the range of the combat radius of the fighter jet was increased. New Grifo fire control radars, having about 75 km range, were introduced, which gave the aircraft capability to fire BVR missile if needed. The metallurgy of the aircraft was overhauled and service life was increased. The capability to do takeoff and landing from motorway was also added. The ROWS also configured the Mirage 5 fighter jets for conducting night operations. In 2001, Indian Tejas made its first flight, and it seemed at that time that India will soon begin its serial production and will begin to induct it in its air force. But the extensive demands of upgradations and improvements resulted in a large number of variants or prototypes of Tejas that not only confused developers but also caused serious delays in the project. The Tejas entered service in 2016. On the other hand, Pakistan adopted a more practical and realistic approach, which helped Pakistan to speed up its program. They focused only on few variants. On 7 April 2004, PF flew prototype 1 for the first time. The maiden flight of the third prototype took place on 9 April 2004. Following the third prototype, several design improvements were developed and incorporated into further aircraft. Prototype 4 and the first to incorporate the design changes was rolled out in April 2006 and made its first flight on 28 April 2006. The basic flight testing was completed in 2007. It was formally presented to the nation as a Pakistan Day gift on 23rd March 2007. A test and evaluation flight was established at PAC Kamra, which carried out the detailed operational evaluation of the aircraft as well as the training of ground and air crew. By the 2008, the JF-17 aircraft has been formally inducted in Pakistan Air Force by replacing A-5 aircraft of an operational squadron of PAF. JF-17 Thunder is an advanced, lightweight, all-weather, day-night, multi-role fighter aircraft. It possesses excellent air-to-air, air-to-surface combat capabilities, the state-of-the-art avionics, optimally integrated subsystems, computerized flight controls, and capability to employ latest weapons provides decisive advantage to JF-17 over adversaries of same class. Production of Block 1 was completed on 18 December when the 50th aircraft was delivered. JF-17A Block 2 is a single-seat variant. Production began on 18 December 2013 and initial testing began on 9 February 2015. Block 2 aircraft make use of composites in the airframe for reduced weight, air-to-air refueling capability, improved radar and avionics, enhanced load-carrying capacity, data link, and electronic warfare capabilities. It was also decided to upgrade all the Block 1 aircrafts to Block 2 level. With the introduction of JF-17 Block 2 as a replacement for A-5 and F-7s, the project successfully achieved its goals. On the other hand, Indian Tejas program was facing delays, and up till 2016 it could induct only two Tejas Mk-1 in its air force. By considering this very slow production rate of Tejas and fast deteriorating rate of MiG-21s, Indian government decided to buy fighter aircraft from Western powers. On 23rd September 2016, Indian Defense Minister and his French counterpart signed a €7.8 billion contract for 36 Rafales. The first 5 Rafales were delivered by 2020, and India is set to have all 36 until 2022. The deal includes weapons and spares, which included Meteor BVRAM missiles. Meanwhile, Pakistan also upgraded its F-16 fleet with the help of Turkey, and these upgraded versions of F-16 has the capability to fully counter the Indian Rafales. The successful upgradation of Mirage fleet, replacement of A-5 and F-7 fleet with JF-17 Block 2 enabled Pakistan to think of giant leaps in its upgradation program. JF-17 Block B was developed and work on JF-17 Block 3 was started. JF-17 B Block 2 is a dual-seat variant of the JF-17 A Block 2. First flight occurred in Chengdu, China on 27 April 2017. Serial production started in 2018. A total of 26 aircraft were built, first 4 at Chengdu and remaining 22 at Kamala. Its multi-roles include use as a JF-17 conversion trainer, lead-in fighter trainer, LIFT, ground attack aircraft, and reconnaissance aircraft. Apart from the dual seat, larger dorsal spine and a more swept back tail. Another difference between the JF-17B and the JF-17A is that the JF-17B carries fuel in its vertical stabilizer, which the JF-17A does not. Together with the 3 external fuel drop tanks, the aircraft can carry a total of 10,000 pound fuel load. JF-17A Block 3 is a single seat variant. First flight occurred in Chengdu, China on 15 December 2019. Two prototypes undergoing flight tests as of December 2020. One in China and the other in Pakistan. Projected to feature further advancements such as NRIET, CETC, KLJ-7A, air-cooled airborne fire control, active electronically scanned array, ASA radar, a 3-axis digital fly-by-wire flight control system, an infrared search and track IRST system, a helmet-mounted display and sight HMDS system, a missile approach warning system MAWS, a new larger and thinner holographic wide-angle head-up display HUD, an enhanced electronic warfare management system, a chin-mounted hardpoint, use of more composites for further weight reduction. But the most prominent update and also the main cause of delay is its new upgraded Klimov RD-93MA afterburning turbofan engine with FADEC and increased thrust and a better thrust to weight ratio. The engine was expected to enter flight test mode towards the end of the 2020, which means the JF-17 Block 3 would enter flight test with the RD-93MA engine sometime in 2022 at the earliest. And the JF-17 Block 3 fighter jets may enter in service up till the end of 2022 or at the beginning of 2023.